Welcome everybody to a brand new episode of Let's Talk About Cigars. My name is Dutch Cigars. Today we have a brand new episode with a brand new product, so let's light one up. So for today's episode, in the last episode I promised you guys I'm going to do a review about a new cigar. And here it is. It's going to be about the new Juan Lopez. This Juan Lopez is a La Casa Albano edition, and right off the bat, so don't get your hopes up. Don't go to the web shop immediately and think like, oh, you can buy it or anything like that. It's the availability is very low, so unfortunately we didn't get in a lot, and we were hoping for more so we could actually sell them to more people, but right now it's already sold out, so sorry for that. But at least now you know how they look, and at the end of the video you will know if it's a good cigar or not, if it's worth it or not, because it's an expensive one. So it comes in this beautiful white, well, beautiful thanks to the Dutch stickers, it isn't, in this white box. Of course, it's a cardboard box that's around a beautiful Hubner type of box that's inside. Never experienced a heavy box like this ever. This is by far the most heavy regular sort of cigar. Of course, you have those beautiful humidors, but sort of regular cigar, it's heavy. It's around 2 kilograms. For comparison, for example, Monte Cristo number 2 box, also 25. Weighs around 700-800 grams. So you can imagine how much heavier this is. Came in like a big box. It was heavy, incredible. So we were like, what is in this? It's just this. So 2 kilograms, it's a lot for a normal box. Let me show you the inside, the cigar, well, let me show you the box, the cigars, tell you a little bit more about the size, the name, and then of course, we're going to smoke it. So let's see. So here it is. Of course, we have the stickers, the seal. I already opened this one before. Beautiful green soft sleeve in it. I do this very well. So here is the beautiful white box. 25 cigars in it. La Casa de Albano logo, nice on it. So this cigar is made, of course, also, finally the name, Selección Especial. So they made this cigar for the 150-year anniversary of Juan Lopez, but also for the 30-year anniversary of La Casa de Albano. So it's quite a special cigar that they chose this one for La Casa de Albano celebration. As you can see, beautiful box, again, very heavy, but you will see why. So this box is a lot more than, it's a lot more like a humidor than just a box. Of course, we have all the standard papers in it. And here is the beautiful, beautiful cigar next to it. Oh, sorry. So the cigar itself, let me take one out. Of course, take the easiest one out. So it has a 52 ring gauge and a length of 170 millimeters. So it's a nice big cigar. Not extremely big, just good big cigar. And this is a beautiful one. Very nice wrapper. Already opened another one, very dark. It looks beautiful. 2 layers, of course. Even the bottom layer has a ribbon like this. So, beautiful. And as you can see, I'm gonna take this one out. As you can see here, the humidor, well, the box closes very tight on it. So I'm pretty sure you can use it as a humidor if you want. There's also a magnetic close somewhere because it shuts quite good. It takes a little bit more force to open it. So I'm pretty sure you can use this as a humidor. That makes the price a little bit better. But if you buy this as a single cigar, it is a quite a steep price. You're paying, let's keep that to the end. So let's first smoke the cigar, light it up and see how good it is. So it's time to cut it. Funny thing is, funny story about this cigar, there should have been a launch party at the December 4th, 2 weeks ago. Finally, it was a party for the Benelux. The release party should have been in Brussels. Since that we had the store, we haven't had any of the release parties. We finally could go there. We invited like 8 or 10 friends to come with us. It was a beautiful evening planned. And then the virus thing happened. And also Brussels had stricter rules. So we couldn't go anymore. So that was a big, big disappointment, because we really wanted to see like one of those parties and of course smoke the cigar. Don't worry. Luckily later on they sent us the cigars and sent us a couple of gifts with it, so we could still smoke it. So let's see how this is. Very good draw. Very nice draw. Not too easy. Of course, I'm gonna use my Dupont Le Grand. First, toast it a little bit. Just like I thought of the cold draw. It's a beautiful, beautiful draw in it. I don't know what I did here with the cut, but. Look how strange this looks. I fucked that one up. Very nice draw. Very nice draw. Is that camera a little bit crooked or not? I got a new standard with a light on it, as you can see. I have to get used to it. So, immediately off the bat, don't know what happened to my cigar here, but it starts to crack. That's too bad. For such a young and fresh cigar, because the box date June 21, of course. Very nice, very nice. As you can see, a lot of smoke, perfect draw. This is how you want it to be. Perfect Cuban draw. Very good. Okay, let's meet at the halfway point, like we always used to do. Yes, halfway point. What a cigar. So, almost at the halfway point. The cigar is burning perfectly. Nice dark ash on it, and a little, yeah, as you saw in the beginning, a little crack in the foot that went a little bit further, so unfortunately the ash fell away, but it was a nice sturdy ash. It's just a good cigar. It's a good cigar, definitely. I have my hopes on it, and it's good. Is it worth that price? Like I said before, the price is high. So the price per cigar of this Juan Lopez is 29 euros. Normal basic price here in the Netherlands. So it might of course vary per country. And I heard these boxes are already going for more than that. So, is it worth more than that? Like I said, the box is like a humidor. So of course, if you buy the whole thing, you have a beautiful humidor for 735 euros. Let me check just to make sure. Oh, €735. €735, you have a beautiful humidor, of course, with 25 delicious big cigars. It's worth it. Is it worth it? Yes. I'm going to say yes on this one. It's worth it. I had less cigars for more money, and that was not worth it. This one, I would say it's worth it. But buying them as singles, €29 per cigar, that's still a lot of money. The humidor just does it for it. The humidor, look how beautiful it is. That does it for that price. Not with just singles. I would say beautiful cigar to buy and smoke. I wonder how well it will age because it's a light cigar. There is some potential in it in the taste, but I don't think this will be a cigar to put in the humidor for 10, 15 years and just let it be. I don't think you will have the best cigar. But so far, I'm really enjoying it. So it's a bit of a mixed feeling. The humidor makes it worth it. Without, I would of course buy it. Always buy one, smoke it, see how it is. But if you have to spend money that it hurts, don't do it. Then you can better buy 3 D4s or something like that. So, yeah, I'm happy. Maybe I will be back at the end, but I don't think so. I'm going to enjoy the rest of the cigar. Thank you for watching this finally new video. Hopefully soon another one will come. Like I said, I have some great new products that I need to show you guys. So thank you for watching, and smoke on. Okay, a little small update at the end. I don't know what is happening to mine. I already had the crack in the beginning, and look, I just hear it cracking and cracking and cracking. Pretty sure, yeah, there's a nasty spot on mine, but I don't mind that. This is too bad. This will probably crack until the bends and take the band off, and the rest will crack, so. Too bad. Still a good cigar though.